I have not looked at that log all the way. Please, can I ask you to sit? The rest of us, the rest remain standing. Let's read the word of God, and then I have not noted the time, so. Ephesians chapter number 6. I'm reading verse 10 to 18. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10 to 18. Ephesians chapter, not first Samuel, Ephesians. Finally, build up your strength in union with the Lord, and by means of his mighty power, put on the whole armor that God gives you, so that you'll be able to stand up against the devil's tricks. For we are not fighting against human beings, but against the wicked spiritual forces in heavenly world, the rulers, authorities, and cosmic powers of this dark age. So put on God's armor. Then, when the evil day comes, you'll be able to resist the enemy's attacks, and after fighting to the end, you will still hold your ground. So stand ready with the truth as a belt tied around your waist, with righteousness as your breastplate, and as your shoe, the readiness to announce the good news of peace. At all times, carry faith as a shield, for with it, you'll be able to put out the burning arrows shot by the evil one, and accept salvation as a helmet, and the word of God as the sword which the Spirit gives you. Do all this in prayer, asking for God's help. Pray on every occasion as the Spirit leads. For this reason, keep alert and never give up. Pray always for all God's people. Father, this morning our prayer is that you speak to us and that we will do that which you tell us to do. For this we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Greet about 2, 3, 4 people around you. Tell them karibu to this express service. Tell them you have liked the way they came. And you know, one of the things that I've discovered is that we are still finding our place. I have missed some of the people that used to be behind me, like in the Kemanis. Now I can see they are very close to this other place. Maybe I'll relocate myself. But let's find our place. He not yet, don't know whether he has found the place yet. Still looking for the place. Pale ataita county yake. Bwana asifiwe sana. Peterson, karibu Kenya. Mulikuja na watu wakatushinda. Abdabe ni maombi yako Cameroon. Uliomba kule walikuja wakashinda wadada yetu. Moja kwa sufuri. So maybe you need to pray for our team then, when it is going over there. It's like, we are glad that you're back. Blessed be the name of the Lord. If you're visiting us for the very first time, you're here, and this is your very first time, if you lift up your hand, we'll spot you quickly, because we want to welcome you. The Lord bless you. It's good to see you in the house. Amen. Kuna mgeni hapa? Kuna mgeni mwingine? Aya, na wewe mwalike wageni. Ibada ya leo, wale waliomba, Kevina aliomba sana kusiwe na jua leo. Mimi nilikuwa nimepigana nikuingie kioo, na aliomba sana kusiwe na jua. Alichomeka sana last Sunday, na tunashukuru Mungu. Inaendelea ikifichika. I promised you that if you see different chairs, those are yours. So those are 100 chairs. That's your contribution, the money you gave last Saturday, and the money you gave on Sunday, the three services, it was 12,000, and then on Saturday it was 56. So the 68, that is the money. Tumibakisha pesa kidogo, kama, less than 100 shillings, but you bought those 100. I told you we'll be buying different colors, so that we can go excusing ourselves from the ones that we are born with. But God is good. I have the testimony. And things are getting better and better. To bless the name of the Lord. standing. Can I ask the guys over there to put the translation, the NIV translation, verse 10 to 13. The new translation, the NIV, New International Version. Finally, be strong in the Lord and in His mighty power. Put on the whole armor of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. For our struggle is not against the flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world. Verse number 13. Therefore, put on the whole armor of God so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand. Can I ask you also if you have King James? If you have King James, the same verses, King James. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against the flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers, and against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore, take unto yourself the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand. I think that is the word that I was looking for. To withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand. So those are the words that I'm looking for, that God wants me to have the grace and power to withstand, and after I withstand, I'm able to stand. When the Lord spoke those words to my heart, I felt excited, because the Lord is telling me that I have the ability to withstand. But withstanding is not enough. I'm supposed to stand after I withstand. Because some of us can withstand but fall, but after I withstand, am I able to stand? Blessed be the name of the Lord. You see, Paul is coming from sharing with us and talking about children. He has talked about children honoring their parents as you start chapter 6. And as you end chapter 5, he's talking about couples. He's talking about wives and husbands. And then he comes to this passage where he's trying to end the writing of the book of Ephesians by trying to tell us that we have war. We are in the battlefield. We are fighting. But he tells us we are not fighting with our children. We are not fighting with our wives. We are not fighting with the church. We are not fighting with the government. We are not fighting. We are not struggling with flesh and blood. But our battles are different. You know, I know you know this, that it used to be drawn in some of the books that this man comes home and he is annoyed. So what does he do? He fights his wife, Sarah. And what does the wife do? Fights the children. And what do the children do? They fight the dog. And what will the dog do? The dog, the cat. You know, it is like everybody is trying to release a steam out. But the battle that we are fighting, actually, if you know, you'll be blessed. Because sometimes we fight the wrong people. For example, you're coming from work and you're frustrated by your employer. And your wife has done nothing, absolutely nothing. But the whole steam is released. Back up to our listener, sweetie. You know, why I've laughed is a little joke that my wife shared with me. And some of you saw it also. That sukari is very cheap. Nahani is very cheap. So this joke was, So instead of calling your wife sweetie or honey, you call her 50 kilos of rice. Oh, my 50 kilos of rice. My 90 kg of sugar. I thought it was very, very interesting. Here you are, frustrated by the day, and the air was not good and conducive for you. But when you get home, everybody has to die for their life. Why? Because they have become the enemy. So Paul is addressing and trying to tell us, no, we are not fighting with flesh and blood, but we are fighting with some powers. We are fighting with some powers. Blessed is the man or woman who know their powers. Does your neighbor know their powers? You know powers. Powers. Spirit in the heavenly places. Powers. Prince of this present darkness. Powers. We inhabit hosts of wickedness. Those are the things and the struggle that we have. But Paul wants us, for us to know that battles, any battle, is very exhausting. Inachosha. Hakuna vita ambayo ni raha. And an exhausted soldier needs to restore his strength, or he becomes an easy target from the enemy. That's why he told, after you will stand, are you able to stand? Because some of us can withstand, but we cannot stand after that. We are the Elijahs. We are able to withstand the prophet of Baal, but we are not able to stand against Jezebel, against the same forces. We are able to withstand great things, but we are not able to stand against some tiny little things that come our way. So battles are interesting. Verse 10 and 11, those verses indicate that the source of our energy is not found within ourselves, but within our Lord Jesus Christ. I told you, I've been looking at ways I can encourage myself. I want to encourage myself. And the Lord is telling me, some of the battles that are there, they are not flesh and blood. I'm not fighting with anybody here. I'm fighting with the forces that be. And once you know that, then your strategy changes. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Your strategy changes. There are three things that I know God wants, why he wants us to be strong. Number one, God wants you to be strong in him because you are in a spiritual battle against the powerful forces of darkness. He wants you to be strong. If you go back to where we read, listen to what Paul is telling us. Finally, build up your strength in union with the Lord and by means of his mighty power. Let's go back to King James. Blessed be the name of the Lord. God wants you to be strong in him. Why? Because you're in a spiritual battle against powerful forces of darkness. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. If you like all what that verse is trying to tell us, that you, God wants you to be strong, and he's telling you how. He wants you to be strong in him, and he wants you to be strong in his power, and he wants you to be strong in his might. In other words, he doesn't want you to use any of your power. There's a song that I sang one time in the office. I had never heard it before. You see, Jesse Dixon died, and I did not know he's dead. You know? So I was Googling his music, and then I saw funeral service, and I said, Allah, Jamal Al-Kufa, eh? And he died a long time ago, a couple of years ago. But I loved his music so much. That why I loved the music is the song that I played that day. That song caused me to shed tears. Because it says like this, that I thought I can make it on my own. I thought I have the power and grace. And he talked about the things that he thought he could do. But the chorus simply says, but I cannot walk even without him. Now, even walking is impossible. So tears started coming out of me because it is true. I thought I could, but I've discovered even walking, I need the Lord. For you, you need to know that you have no power nor grace. No wonder Paul is telling us, we need his strength, we need his power, and we need his might. Blessed be the name of the Lord. But you know what? One of the biggest challenges that I found in the house of God, and I've been mentioning it even as I share, is that if we are not careful, we can make the devil the king of our homes. We talk about him in the morning, we talk about him during noon time, we talk about him in the evening, and some of us, God help you, don't talk to him that time, but we talk about him when we are going to sleep. No wonder the dreams that we dream are scary. Can I tell you this thing? Talk about Jesus in the morning. Talk about Jesus at noon time. Talk about Jesus before you sleep. Listen to a good sermon or listen to his word before you go to bed. Because there are some of us, we saturate ourselves with the devil. And the devil becomes so big. And you know what? The devil is not as big as you think. I normally say, when he goes to Pakistan and there is chaos, he is not in Nairobi. Because he cannot be omnipresent. So when you're exhorting him, you're trying to say he's able to be in your bed and at the same time be in Pakistan. Never! The people that are under are demons. They are small soldiers. And you can handle them. Because even the devil himself, you can. Let me give you an illustration. There was this guy who, his work was to clean the Mari Simba Nakakwa Zoo. Whatever. Hiyo nyumba ya simba. Na kuna watu walikuwa wamekuja kutembea kwa zoo kuona simba. Wakaona jamaa ameingia ndani na hana hajilindi. Na hana wasiwasi. Akaanza kufagia na kuosha. Na akaenda pale ile simba alikuwa ameketi akampiga teke. Na kuna jamaa kule nje anamwambia, "Nashindwa jamaa." Akamaliza kufanya kila kitu. Akamwekea chakula na akaenda akamfuruta kidogo zile vitu zake. Simba akaondoka, akaenda kwa kando. Sasa alipotoka kuna jamaa alikuwa amemwona. Akakimbia kumuuliza, "Hey, you are so courageous. Oh man, when I grow up I want your courage." And the guy said, no courage. "Hey, how can you play with the lion inside?" He said, "No, that lion has no teeth." Is true about the devil. Why Jesus can help us to handle the devil is because the devil is toothless. No wonder Peter tells us he is like a rolling lion, toothless rolling lion, but he's not a lion. We cannot exalt the devil, and the devil does not scratch us. In where I come from, we normally say, the devils, the demons, they get so mad about us because we are the ones that celebrate. Feast on them, we are the ones that exalt them. But the devil, we need to tell the devil, you have no place here. When you are in Middle East, like right now, I understand he is in Syria this morning. How can he be in Zimbabwe at the same time? So whoever demons are around, we know your master is not around. So you cannot be here. You have to be there. The other thing I've said here, which is something that I also like saying, is this. If you also, they did a devil, you will see demons everywhere. Look at your neighbor. Is that a demon next to you? I'm just telling you, is that a demon next to you? But I tell you, if you're not careful, some of the books that you read, some of the videos that you see, some of the people that speak into your life actually tell you demons are everywhere. Brother, bless you. You got married just the other day. Can you imagine somebody telling you that you have a demon in your house? What are you going to do with him? Deal with him. But what that happens because we listen, and I don't want to say this, and I'm not naive. That you people, although you listen to me on a Sunday morning, I'm not the only preacher you like to listening to. Hello. But please allow me to help you. Because if you open your eyes to see the devil everywhere, you will have a problem. Atinajua hiyo uwanja yako. Bishop alikwambia nini? Alikusalimia na mkono. You know, naweza kukusalimia na mkono wa kushoto kwa sababu umeumia, sio? Atinakwambia nini? You see, what we are trying to do is to coax the devil. And I said in this chat, sometimes we listened and we read books until we were so scared to get into a matatu. Because we had believed the devil is actually seated next to you. And that was the material. So what did we do? You sit in a seat, but you know the guy next to you could be the devil himself. But I say again, I will be with you in that command. I normally say then, what Christians, or Kenyans, or Africans, we can become traditionalists, or we can believe in ATR, what is this theologians do, African traditional religion. What do they believe in? African traditional religion, first of all, they believe there is nothing without a cause. So, there must be a cause. El Nino, during the El Nino, when the opposition were very busy, we were told by the guys that were in Moi's side, hata hiyo mvua ya kuua watu ni opposition. Mvua inatoka tu lakini ndio. So you allow the devil, you push yourself to a place where your mother huwa amekupa maziwa, hakukutupa kwa pipa, hakukutupa kwa choo, amekunyonyesha, amekulea, umefikisha miaka 80, miaka hiyo yako umefikisha, alafu kwa ghafla tu unaambiwa anaweza kuwa shetani. Na unaamini ati I was told that I agree. My mother, alinipeleka nikiwa katoto kadogo. Watu ya rika yangu, Bwana asifiwe. Kule mama yako alikupeleka ukatumikie. I'm telling guys of my age, where you are taken in that small village. They were taking you what in your giri. You know what that means? In Italy? Can I go over? I'm not going to get that. To report in a perequa, Chochoro, Zikini, who will be perequa Muranga long before. Uku kona. I love today, when I'm this age, and I say, I see my mother. My mother told me to be cut that. Ooh. So Paul is telling us, we not only withstand the forces, but after we withstand them, we need to stand up. Oh, I'm born again, I resist the devil, but as I resist him, I'm supposed to stand as a Christian. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Oh, this is a wonderful church to be in. So the devil is not everywhere. The devil is not everywhere, but there are principalities and powers. Do accidents happen? Are they caused sometimes by demons? Yes! I'm not saying demons are not there, but I'm saying I will not glorify them. If they die, maybe around the highways, we will go there and sanctify that place. But we will not keep on saying, oh, apane pabaya sana, chetanya metawala. Let's not allow the devil to rule. He has no power. The devil has no power. Remember what Paul is telling us? He's telling us we wrestle against principalities. We are wrestling with some organized powers. No wonder in the book of Jude, and people have kept on repeating it many, many times, when the act archangel was struggling with the devil over the death of Moses, he discovered that the Lucifer was senior in the hierarchy. And therefore he decided he will not use his power. He said, and the Lord Jesus rebukes you. Some of the forces are greater than us. And that's what this passage is trying to tell us. They are principalities. Kenya has a principality. And we know our principality. Some of us know that every 5 years, he raises his ugly head. But the problem is this, and I'll tell you the problem. The problem is that we pray for 3 months. We fast for 3 months. We go to the mountain for 3 months. Then after 3 months, we come back to church and wait for another 4 years, 9 months. And the devil knows that. So he terrorizes us. But we need to know that if we need to keep him out, we keep him out the 5 years. There is no time that we're not praying. There's no time we're not resisting him until all those years are gone. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Battles are exhausted. Rulers. We also resist in powers. They are powers. Powers. And there are many powers around us. Many, many powers around us. We are not fighting against human beings, but against the wicked spiritual forces in the heavenly world. The rulers that rule in those worlds. Authorities that control those worlds. The cosmic powers of this dark present age. But God wants us to be strong in him because we are in a spiritual battle. Spiritual battle. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Now, yesterday, this came into my heart so heavily. We had gone to the G12, we had gone to pray with the Reverend Wade. When we were leaving, my heart, I felt, would we be the ones that are on trial? The church. Would we be the ones? Would we be the ones that are being put on the misery? How do we take it? Those are the questions that came. How do we take it? When we leave each other, what goes into our mind? Do we look for answers? And God does not answer questions. He answers prayer. God, we go to pray. Because anytime we go to look for answers, we'll get them. Hebu niambie. Alianguka na mkaka. Niambie. Oh. Kumbe aliwekewa mwalimu chini ya kanyaga akaanguka. You know, you will have a lot of reasons. You will have jibu everywhere. Instead of praying that God will heal Reverend and bring him back. Because the thing is, he got sick, he fell down. We know the devil could have been involved, but we will not exalt the devil because we know the devil missed it. Actually, when I was leaving that place, I told the devil, you missed it. He was there, but he is now coming back. Now, don't tell me anything. Don't preach me any other sermon. He was in a coma, and now he's not. The devil, you have lost it. Yes. There is no way you can preach in the gospel. Usikubali mtu mwingine kuambia anything else. Do you know, when my father died, I was even shown the pastor who killed him. Nilifanya nini? Atio, my pastor, najua aliyeua baba yako. And then, ikaambiwa jina yake. Halafu ikauliza, walifanya nini? My father was sick for over 1 year. Walikuwekea sumu. Walikuwekea wapi? Alitoka siku moja wakuwekea kwa chai. Ilikuwa ya turungi ama ni ya maziwa. So, And you look at me and say, yes, and I want your answer. And then you know, but oh, glory to God. You know, but the counter, the counter, the counter. Yule. What's the video in one video? What kind of a position? Yule. Number two. God wants you to be strong in Him because the spiritual battle can only be won, first of all, by putting on His armor. He talks about the armor, And you all know this, and I don't want to repeat again, that the armor that God has given us covers the front only. Sasa, hakuna mugongo. Kwa hivyo ukionyesha adui mugongo, you are done. Two, what He has given us are two types of battle gears. One is to protect you from the schemes of the devil, and the other one is to fight. So you are either on the two things, to stand and to fight. There is no two way, is to stand and to fight. Put on the whole armor of God. Why do you do so? Because He wants you to put on the whole armor of God so that you can stand the ground and resist the devil. We have sung wonderful songs today. That in one of it we say we have seen the King, the Lamb exalted, lifted up high. We have sung that we know that God, He is everything. He can do all things. There is very little that we do ourselves. We have sung and blessed the Lord in those directions. We have done that. So we know. And I don't know what happens. I told you I'm encouraging myself. Because the Lord has to tell me why this happening to me and that. And He tells me, you're not fighting against flesh and blood. They are forces. Can those forces use people? Fine, they can. But I'm not going to fight the people. I'm going to see the power behind. Has somebody ever done something to you and you have kept on saying, I? Who is CNA? Have you ever said something like that? Because it's through CNA. Ah, who you? Have you? Umepewa ushuhuda na mtu. Akwambia nimeshika fulani. Amefanya hivi na hivyo. Why are you saying sio yeye? Because sio yeye ni nguvu zilizo si yeye. Yeye unavyomfahamu ana uwezo wa kukataa, lakini kuna mapepo labda yamemchanganyisha. Sio yeye, hawezi. Kumefanyika nini? There are some powers and forces that have come. But the point that I want to bring to you is this: God wants me to be strong in Him because the spiritual battle can only be won, first of all, by withstanding. And we can only withstand the devil by the word of God. Tutampinga shetani kwa neno lake Mungu. We will, all that I know is God speaking, I will receive. But everything that I know is not God. Whether it will be spoken by Bishop Kimani, I will refuse. That's what I'm trying to tell you. Are you hearing what I'm saying? So if I came here and I looked at you and I told you, Bure Kabisa, what are you going to do? Bishop, let me see your Bure Kabisa. But if I tell you, you are blessed of the Lord and God is going to prosper you, all that I do say, it's mine. That's what I'm trying to say. You grab that which is yours and you cancel that which is not yours. I was listening to a conversation. We had a conversation with my son. And my son is good. He is very good. Some of you know. He is so good that he has gone out of his way to help a lot of us. Sometimes I even don't know where he gets that money from. But he is so good. Put him in any committee and he will give. Even the church committee. He's just a good giver. So the other day we had a conversation because he's getting married. You know, when he gets married, maybe you will not be telling him to greet me, but now you can tell him to greet me. But when he gets married, Katua kusalimia mke wako, sio? Salimia mke wako. So we were having conversation actually last week after he had tea here. And he had a conversation with my elder brother. And this is what my elder brother told him. See, your father got all the blessings from my father. That's what he told him. So my son comes and he says, when you are going to repair barakazote. So I told my son, hakukuwa na baraka. Kile kilikuwa kwa ni opportunity. I took opportunity. The first one, opportunity was to get saved. And I got saved. The second one was to cancel poverty. And I did. And if that is the blessing, we were all given. What he did with his, I don't know. What I did with mine, I know. Are you getting the point?
Yes.
That God has, it's all yours. I receive this and I cancel this. One time I was told by someone, it was 1974. The point is, you learn to cancel and you learn to. So if someone has come and told you you are the devil on the face, tell him, I am not, because I am blessed. Blessed be the name. I want to finish by the last point. Number three, God wants you to be strong in him, because the spiritual battle is won through prayer. You see, putting on the whole armor of God, like some of us do, is not victory. Putting it on is not victory yet. It is a dresser. If I ask, how many of you can go from their homes without clothes? We're talking to after shower. No. The other day, a German woman did that. And he took her and a book. And the door cut off and I have a Sasa hapa town na angalia anafanya shopping. Mama anafanya shopping. Watu wakaanza kuzunguka huyo mama. Katoto wakaanza kulia. Sasa ndio alichukua mtoto wa kaya. Sijui kama ni. But can I tell you the truth? A lot of you leave your home with no clothes on. Put on woolen. So don't laugh. I mean, it's when they talk, some of us leave home without the whole armor of God. No wonder the battles that come our way, we have no resistance. Because we are naked. Vaa nguo za vita. Lakini ukisha vaa nguo za vita, sasa, hapa ndipo ushindi wako upo. Bwana Yesu apewe sifa. Hivi ndivyo maandiko inatuambia hivi. Do all this in prayer. Do all this in prayer. If I'm going to be an overcomer, if I'm going to withstand and stand, then I'll be a woman and a man of prayer. I will pray to the Lord. I will get my prayer right. I will pray without ceasing. You know, there are some of you that can pray for hours, and some of you pray for others that have known they cannot pray for 10 minutes. But let me tell you something. I would rather someone who prays for 10 minutes but prays many times in the day than one person who prays for only 1 hour, but he doesn't pray again the whole week. Pray always without ceasing. Don't pray for 5 hours. Pray for 10. Pray. Keep on praying. Pray when you're moving. Pray when you're driving. Pray when you're cooking. Pray when you're whatever you're sitting down. Pray when you're standing up. Because if you're put on the whole armor of God, for you to win the battle, some of us can do that. But even with that prayer, pray all the time. You're not going to say, carry a book to read. I also want to tell some of you, carry a prayer with you. Keep on praying. When you're waiting, pray. Now, see your work. Yesterday or the day before yesterday, we met one of the mshirikas here. Tukafukua kio tumsalimie. Si tukainua mikono juu, lakini yeye hakuinua yake. Yeye alikuwa anasifu tu, anaimba tu, oh may God help you. Na alikuwa akiimba papo, wacha ile ya kisirisiri. Yake ni ile. Kama ni rock of ages, clap for me. Na uta mwinua mikono, na yeye anapiga wimbo wake amepanda hapa, akielekea upande wa milima. What I'm saying, pray without ceasing. If you put on the whole armor, the most precious thing that you need to keep on buying your armor is to keep on doing what? Pray. And not only pray. Pray also with supplication. Pray with supplication. Pray with intercession. Pray, pray, pray. Intercede, declare something that God can do something for this nation. Do that. Pray that this church will be changed. That people will not live for others. Atena kuangalia, anaona shetani. Hebu muangalie jirani yako. Nini hapo unaona pepo hapo? Hapo kuna pepo umeona hapa. Ai. Unajua siri ile nilijua hata kule nimeisha kupita sasa. Nikichimba chini nitakuta karatasi. Haleluya. Wale ambao wanaonaga shetani kila mahali, hiyo ya plastic, ni nani amefichwa huko? Shetani. Kwa hivyo hakuna mahali pazuri pa kuishi. Nao kweli. Ni wapi sasa pazuri kwa kuishi? Ni kwa Yesu tu. Pray without ceasing, put on the whole armor of God so that you can stand the trials that come away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. I want to tie this by saying this. Remember that your strength comes from God. In the hand of God, He will not let you go. The power of His might, the grace could be very loosely translated, let the grip of His hand hold on you. Hold you. We don't have a hold on God. He is the one that has a hold on us. Blessed be the name of the Lord. How do we win the battle? We put on the whole armor of God. But pray, 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 pray. Blessed be the name. Najua kuna kaujumbe unajaribu kumaliza kana kata. Na masaa nayo imeisha. Hebu tuinuke, tusimame. Situombe tu, hata kama ni dakika moja. Situombe tu, ufungue kinywa chako tu, ujiombee. Hallelujah. Nifungua kinywa chako tu, jiombee tu. Wewe sema kitu. Kwa sababu, for you to withstand, you have to put on the whole armor of God. But for you to win the battle, prayer. Prayer without ceasing. Prayer with intercession. Prayer, 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 prayer is the key. And this month is a month of prayer. Pray, 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 pray that God will give you a release upon you. That God will release a blessing upon you. That the Lord will open the door before you. That God will help you to withstand the forces of the devil. And after you have withstood them, you will be able to stand them again. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we want to thank you and bless you. We want to honor you, dear Father, because you are a God and beside you, there is none other. You are the great Redeemer. You are the great God. Dear Father, we knew we can win all the battles that are before us because you are greater than they that are in the world. Because you live inside us. You are held us. Your grip is stronger but than the grip of the devil. We will not let go of everything, devil. There is no devil in our house. There are no devils and demons that live with us. The devil and demons are outside. The principalities and powers are outside. And they should remain outside. In the mighty name of Jesus. Rock of ages, clap for me. Let me hide.